Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hello everyone, this is Jacob Wilson recording my first Cube draft. Cube is a very personal experience, so a lot of the picks aren't necessarily the right pick. I'm just going to pick for the style of deck I like to play. And normally I like to play a base blue deck, splashing 2 to 3 to 4 colors. So I basically always just take dual lands above almost any other card. I would take like bombs, like Chase the Mind Sculptor, Treachery, and then dual lands, and then filler. Because all the cards in Cube are so good, you don't really need to worry about getting playables. I just take good mana fixing, and then your deck is normally pretty good and filled with good cards. You just want to have a consistent mana base. Thragtusk is very good, but I'm definitely going to take Underground Sea, and Marshlots is the second best card for me. There's no good mana card. There's no good land here. Firelithgit is pretty poor. So, and Seagate Oracle is pretty bad too. So I'm just going to take Findhorn Elves. I think it has the highest potential upside. It could be a green ramp deck if the blue doesn't work out. Or green-blue, perhaps. I like Forbid a lot, but I like it more than the other 3-mana counter spells, but it's still not that different. I'm just going to take a Hollowed Fountain here. Alright, this draft is going pretty well. It may not look like my deck's very good, but I like it. Here I'm going to take Creeping Tar Pit. I'm very glad to take all the manlands highly. Tar Pit, Colonnade, Ravine. They're all great. This pack is pretty poor. I think the best options are Mishra's Factory, Obstinate Baloth, and Time Warp. Time Warp is not a very good card, but if I end up with a lot of Planeswalkers, it could end up being very powerful. So I'll take it, and I might not play it. Here I've picked between a Fetch Land and a Treetop. The cycle of tap fetch lands aren't particularly good, but I already have a couple of dual lands, so I will take grasslands. Right now it can find any color except for red, so that's pretty good. Preordain is great. I like Preordain, Ponder, Impulse, all the cards that add a lot of consistency to your deck. I don't like taking dual lands that are not blue, like Stomping Ground, for instance. Rude Awakening is a potential win condition, but I don't think it's particularly good. Here, I think I'm just going to take Strangrue Geist. I'm probably not going to play anything I take out of this pack. Here, I'll just take Awakening Zone. I might not end up green. But so far, most of my cards are green. Let's take Oren Viper. It's a Death Touch Ophidian. It's pretty good. Putrefy is okay, but I think I'm just going to take Shivan Reef. There are potentially so many powerful cards in Cube that I just want to leave myself open to the possibility of playing them if I do open them or get past them. Okay, this pack is pretty poor. There's not a good card for me to take, so I'm either going to take Rocky Tar Pit or Water Grave. I don't like Ancient Tomb that much in slower decks. I'm just going to take the Water Grave. It's a pretty close pick. I'm definitely unhappy with the pack. Whereas this pack has a lot more powerful cards. Because of how late the Putrefy came around in the first pack, I think I'm very likely to wheel Prodigious Steed or Maelstrom Pulse. I'm just going to take Birds of Paradise. Aetherwing and Jit are also potential picks, but I would prefer Birds. Okay, here I'm just going to take Avacyn's Pilgrim. So my deck is kind of a mess. I don't know exactly what's going on. I'd like to get some Planeswalkers, but we don't have that much time left in the draft. This pack is pretty poor. I could take Ponder or Chainer's Edict or Borderland Ranger, but I'm going to take Baleful Strix. I think I have enough dual lands that I can play it. Okay, perfect. Here's the Sorin. At this point, I don't really care what the Planeswalker is. I have so many mana guys and Time Warp and defensive, resilient creatures that Planeswalkers are going to be good. And basically, regardless of what color they are, I'm going to take them. Okay, this pick is between Smother and Bant Charm. I'd like to have some cheap removal. And I'm going to take the Bant Charm because it's, obviously, it's more versatile, and I think my mana base can support it. Okay, here we have Edric, which is great with mana guys. Not so much Birds of Paradise, but with the other ones. And not only can you play Edric on turn two, but it makes your one mana creatures into a threat. So I'll definitely take that. Ooh. Mist Rainforest is great, but there's also Dismember. Dismember is a premium card. I don't know why I'm getting it 8th pick. It's great in every single deck. But Misty would add a lot of consistency to my deck. Let's see. I have 13 playables. I'll probably get enough in the last pack. I'll just take Misty here. This pack is pretty poor. Okay, here I'm just gonna take Snuff out. I have Underground Sea, Watery Grave, and a couple of fetch lands, so it's pretty similar to Dismember, which I was eager to get. Let's see. I could either take Temple Garden, which deals me 2 damage, or I could take Savannah. At this point, it looks like my deck is every color but red, so I don't think Lava Claw Reaches is a good pick. So I'll just take Chroma's Vengeance, I suppose. I'm not gonna play it. At this point, I could take Borderland Ranger, which synergizes well with my deck, but instead I'm gonna take Mana Tithe to potentially tilt my opponent. I love cards like Mana Tithe and Force Spike and Daze. They're actually very good cards, but for some reason people are extremely frustrated when they play against them. I probably won't play Phantasmal Bear, it's a pretty poor card. But I am happy to get this Ranger of Eos pretty late. I have a couple one drops.